in the middle eighties. And when I moved into that area, it was. When I moved into this neighborhood, it was an African-American neighborhood with children and grandparents and parents. There was not much crime in the area at that time. But as the older generation died out, mm-hmm. the younger generation neglected the properties.
That's right.
They moved to DeSoto, Cedar Hill, wherever. And this property was neglected in the area that I moved to. So I watched drugs come into this neighborhood, take over a lot of the houses. We had slum lords that rented mm-hmm. to drug dealers. I watched drug dealers pay the slum lords. So I'm looking at all of this right in front of my where I live. So I took like a yellow tablet like this, a pen, and I would sit on the porch and I would start writing. And I started calling the police with very little trust because I had called police. This is in the 80s. I would say I wanted to remain anonymous. I'm looking at somebody doing drugs. Could you send the police to that place? Instead of them going where the drugs were, they came straight to my front door. So this made me distrust calling the police. This all started in the 80s. I didn't give up. I just started calling 911, and I got to be so popular with 911. I have some policemen that's been on the force a long time that's come back and told me, I remember you when you were the only one in Dauphin Heights calling the police department. So now in 2004, my husband passed in 92. The drugs were rampant. Police were getting a little bit better because I started reporting police on the 911 system. In 2004, we organized a crime watch group. And I had made it my purpose since they had elected me to be the president. I made a promise to myself in that neighborhood. I'm going to work with the police department, the city of Dallas, whoever's in the mayor's office, the city council. And I can truthfully say, when you be persistent, and you really care about where you live, and you step up, you stand up, go to Chief Brown. Hey, Chief Brown, they doing so-and-so. Can you do something about it? Mayor Romans, I need a contact. You have to get up and go. And it's no such thing as you cannot trust Chief Brown, mayor, anyone else, city attorneys. You just have to open your heart. You trust in God, and you
Amen,
hold people accountable. Mm-hmm. And from all this experience, that was in 2004, and I look at Chief Brown, Mr. Perkins, Mayor Rollins, I don't know how to say Mr. Hey, Tom, how you doing, you know? Can you come help me get rid of this house? But when you get out and you start talking and you honest about what you're doing in your neighborhood, all of these people sitting in here, including the residents, everybody is going to pitch in. Somebody's going to call the police. And trust in the police department. Who else can you trust outside of the police department and God? So, no, I support the police and everything that they do. I don't have too much input on Mr. Harper. I will say I knew Mr. Harper. I have friends in Dixon Circle. To be honest about it, I've reported that drug house. Okay, you have to have trust. I did that. Now I'm saying what I did. No policeman is going to say telling anybody Miss Hill turned that drug house in. I believe in what we stand up for. And and all of us do. You have to trust the police department. You have to work with your code and city people. You have to do all this stuff. You can't do it by yourself. I'm sorry Mr. Harper's dead, but you have to look at what Mr. Harper was doing. If we get into a fight, I don't know about that. You know what I'm saying? When you're fighting for your life, it could go either way. So I don't have too much comments on that issue.
Thank you, Ms. Hill, for that.